In this tutorial, you will learn how you can extract an email address from any text. So the example I want to show you is this over here. So it is an email, and in this case, it is an order with some order details. And then over here, you see an email address, right? So we want to extract this email address from this text. And the method I'm about to show you works with any kind of text. So what we do is we're going to create a scenario, and over here we're going to start with watching for emails inside our inbox, because in this example, right, we have this email over here. If you have a different kind of text, then you can skip this step. But I want to watch emails inside my inbox. So here I select the folder inbox, and then the subject should contain order and hashtag. So then what it's going to do, every 15 minutes is going to check in my inbox if there's any new emails that match those conditions. Now then, what we want to do is we want to extract that email address, right? So to do that, we have to match a pattern inside that email for anything to look for that looks like an email address. So to do that, we're going to use the text parser. So you just type in here, text parser, go to text parser, and then here, match pattern. And then the pattern we want to look for is this over here. So this is a regular expression. It sounds super duper techy, but it's basically just saying like, okay, anything here before the at, then anything after the at, then there should be a dot, and then anything after that dot. So then over here you see an example email, and then over here it says like, okay, there was one match. If I would change this to this without a dot, for example, then it knows like, hey, this is not a valid email address. So we're going to copy this over here, and we simply paste this in here, and this is everything you need to know about regular expressions. Then everything here you can leave the same, except here we have to enter the text. We want to look for that pattern, right? So because we have an email over here, what I'm going to do is here I select text content, so that way it's going to search for the text content inside that email. But obviously, if you use something else than an email where you want to look for an email address, then you need to select a different variable there. So I'm going to click here OK, and then I will click Save. And then over here, you see that we get a little warning. It says a transformer should not be the last module in the root. And it says that because this is not really doing something, it's just extracting something, but not really like executing something. But I just want to show you what this is doing. So we're going to click here Run Once, Run Anyway. And it's going to search in my inbox for emails with order hashtag in the subject line. So that takes a second. And over here, you see that it found an email. So here, order hashtag 000126. And if I go here to text content, then over here, you see the order details of this order. And then here you see an email address. And then the text parser was looking for a pattern, right? So then over here, you can see that it found here johndoe@gmail.com, because here you see that it says johndoe@gmail.com. That's basically already it. But then if you want to use it somewhere else, let's say maybe in a Google Sheet module, something like that, then over here we look for Google Sheets, and then maybe we want to add a row, and then we set it here. Okay, select a spreadsheet. Then here I have a list of people. Then we select the sheet itself. Sheet one, table contains headers, yes. And over here you see that I have a Google Sheet with the headers name, email, and date. So in this case, I'm only going to populate email over here because that's what we extracted. So then over here you see this $1. So this is the result from that text parser. So I just put that in here, click OK, click Save. Then this time you see that there is also no warning because this is not the last module in the scenario. And then I'm going to click Run Once to demonstrate again that it works. So then it's looking for another email. It found an email here, order 000127. And then here in the text content, we see, okay, we have the order details in here. Then it extracted again the email address, and then it added a new row to our Google Sheet. And then you see here that it added to row B or column B, johndoe@gmail.com. So that's how you extract an email from a piece of text. In this case, an email, for example, but you can use it for all kinds of different things. I hope this is helpful. And if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below.